Welcome to my channel, Leboku International New Yam Festival. My name is Onen Matthew Levinus, aka Sunday Ntangbo. Here I drop videos on Leboku Festival, the historical and spiritual events that portrays the rich culture of the people of Yako, one of the largest villages in West Africa by landmarks. Today I'll be dropping a new video on the Leboku Festival documentary. If you are new to my channel and you are here to subscribe, please kindly click on the subscribe button below this video. Just click on the subscribe button. Once you do that, you'll be the first to get notified whenever we upload new videos. If you enjoy what we are doing and you like our videos, please kindly give this video a thumbs up. Just give this video a thumbs up. And also, drop a comment in the comment section saying, Umututu, we love you. Just drop a comment right now in the comment section saying, Umututu, we love you. Once you do that, this video is going to be showed to more persons. Without wasting much time, let's jump into the full documentary of the Leboku Festival. Ugep, the headquarters of Yako local government area of Cross River State, an urban settlement with decent and extraordinary road network. It is believed to be the largest village in West Africa by landmarks. However, visitors are drawn in every part of the country during August to Ugep due to the unique and cultural activities. Nevertheless, Ugep is usually the center of events during the month of August, as the indigenous celebrate the MTN-sponsored Leboku New Yam Festival. Leboku, traditionally, among all events, is celebrated to venerate the gods and ancestral spirits for bountiful harvest on yam, regarded as the king of all crops.
We celebrate our ancestors. We thank God for giving us, for making us survive the period of hunger. You know, in those days, after the planting season, it used to be period of hunger. That period of hunger is between the months of April, May, June, July. We are regarded as hunger period at that time. So in August, where our yams mature and we harvest them, we celebrate Leboku to thank God and also celebrate ourselves for those who would have survived that hunger period.
After every farming season, the farms have been cleared, everything has been done, the harvest has come, we now eat and rest as part of that. We're looking for another cultivation year. So Leboku is about agriculture, it's about cultural values. It's about what their, the people's philosophy. It's about their aspirations. And in fact, their travel.
Since the beginning of MTN sponsorship with the Cross River State Government on Leboku, the festival has gained a wider audience and international recognition due to the rich cultural events and innovative add-ons, which include Mr. and Miss Leboku Beauty Pageant, the biggest yam contest, giveaway night, football competition, and International Day. All these are geared towards enriching and giving back to the Yako people. The 32-day activities of the Leboku Festival starts with the Etikekumi, a visitation to the farm road to accept palm wine and sundry gifts. On that day, tappers give out their palm wine for free. That is the Leboku Kipili, the traditional wrestling festival, church thanksgiving service, as well as Leboku Pom, a traditional offering of supplication and appeasement to the gods of the land, are also held as part of the festivity to usher the new year. However, coming next is the breaking of firewood by the Obolopun of Ugep, which will be used for the midnight fire called Okundi.
Yes. No worry, sir. Absolutely.
Days later, also is the Janemboku, the Women's Festival Day, when women are showered with gifts by their loved ones and friends as a symbol of their appreciation of their roles in the family building. It is also characterized by traditional dances as well as gathering of women to treat farm issues. The Janemboku ends with MTN-sponsored Mr. and Ms. Leboku Beauty Pageant, which celebrates outstanding young boys and girls from Ugep who have demonstrated an in-depth knowledge of their culture for the prestigious crown in male and female categories.
When it comes to marriage, I want a vow.
Leboku Men Festival Day. On this day, the men receive gifts from their spouses and loved ones. This event also paved way for the next atmosphere with the emergence of the Etangala. The Etangala masquerade, whose only outing is on this day, spice up the event. The masquerade has a way of lightening the atmosphere. The moment the masquerade emerges, it is followed all over the town by youths who hit two sticks against each other and produces a distinct sound as they follow the masquerade around the town. By midday, on the Leboku day, the Obolupunanis Binas Council of Chiefs file out in a chain of command in the central playground to the beat of the Ekoe drums. Sporadic gunshots are heard as Ugep hunters compete on a shootout. When the men are done, the women emerge to spice up the events. At the end, the Okpebri, who is the chief priest, performs the mandatory spiritual closing ceremony. There is a few day rest after the Leboku, after which is the Yekpi. Young men and maidens are paraded in the town in a ceremony that is believed to usher a great peace and prosperity. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, kindly give this video a thumbs up. Just click on the like button and also drop a comment in the comment section saying, just drop a comment right now saying, Umotutu, we love you. Once you do that, this video is going to go viral. Thank you. Stay tuned. We love you.